lots of speed. Okay everyone, welcome back to the channel. Hopefully I won't run out of camera battery today, and hopefully I've got my microphone sorted out. Quick update, failed my mod 1 test, not going fast enough on the last test, the obstruction, on 45 kilometers per hour instead of 50, so that was annoying. A general remark, and the reason why I bought this bike and cancelled my mod 2, because I wouldn't have been able to train and get a mod 1 again in before the mod 2 was booked, but anyway, that's neither here or there. It was generally thought that I needed a bit more experience, which is something I had been pondering for the last few months, even going back to the shop and asking and friends and all this sort of stuff. So that's what I did. I went back. Some lovely people who had my bike waiting for me there, the ADV 350. That was cool. Actually doing 60 now, I don't know why I'm sleeping. So I went and bought a CB125 F. This is the 2019 model. 10,000 miles or so when I bought it. Full service, and an MOT, blah blah blah. And what I plan to do is spend a month or two doing this kind of thing and riding it to work, all weathers. It's now October, so rain's gonna potentially start coming my way. Get back from this lorry a little bit, get a bit of his backdraft. Too close. Only a full rest, too close. Come back a bit, ease off a bit. Yeah, so I'm going to do my photo journeys, and this is the first one on a motorised bicycle, motorbike. It's not the ADV I hoped for, but I can make all my mistakes on this one, hopefully not too many, and then we can all have much more fun later on. So, I'm going to put the name of the hill, I think it's Huddington or something like that. It's the highest peak in the Chilterns. And I'm at Denham now. So, I'm going on A roads, of course, because I'm a learner. Even though I'm on this big A road. It's the A40 to M40. Comes M40 in a second. Just check my, they're not coming. And they come down there a bit quick. Windy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop talking. This will be video only for the journey to the hill, unless of course something happens. Morning there, Doris. Doris, I call Doris, Google Maps Doris, just in case you're wondering. Coming off, or is he going on? What's he doing? Got slow down here, got traffic lights. Okay, so I'm in third, probably a bit low. I'm going to go in slow. I've also, just before I sign off, today I added these wind guards to my hands. Yesterday or the day before I added the PUIG, PUGE, whatever they call it. The PUGE. I'm going to let him know I'm going right because he's up my arse. Yeah, so look, before I sign off, so I added the PUGE windscreen, which has helped immensely with the wind buffering, because it's quite windy, as you can probably tell. I added the hand windshield thingies that you can see there. And I've also added the those things that stop your visor steaming up. I can't remember the brand name. I'll put it all underneath. I'm not sponsored, so what I put them there, you know, maybe you might want to add them to yours to get the benefits I've got, which is less buffering on the chest of you for your wind, you know, for the wind. Whoa. Why are you stopping? You can still. Oh. Okay. Right, so yeah, so I'm going to leave it there. Enjoy the ride. I'm going to put some music on underneath this and only butt in if I see anything of interest or can remember anything. Okay, enjoy the music and the ride. See you at the hill. note to self. Quite windy today. Had a pint and a meal in this pub on the right. The Ivy House, very nice it is too. It's a Fuller's pub, so I think it's just a standard Fuller's menu, which, you know, isn't bad. Yeah, so back again, just had a thought. Because I'm learning, any of you experienced riders, I'm going to leave this video in warts and all, so if I make any obvious mistakes or any general advice you could give me, please do, you know, because that's helping me and anyone else who's learning, and it's gratefully received and understood. Now back to the music. Clear. Okay. Nationals. I can get there. then I'm going to cut in again. Yeah, just a little, another little note. I've had this bike now 3 or 4 days, driven it to work and back. I've done 152 miles. And I must say, on roads like this, you know, 50 mile an hour, which is the limit on this particular road, bike feels really nice. Just cruising along, taking it all in. So yeah, had a new 60, but that's scratching the arse out of it. And people can always overtake if necessary. Anyway, back to music. what I say, it's early October. And what a lovely day we've got. He gave you a funny look, didn't he? Oh well. Yeah, what a lovely day to do whatever this is to doing. Gonna have a cargo check. Make sure the bag's on properly. Yep. Still good.
String. very nice, isn't it? Ah, look at them cottages, man. Wow. Very beautiful. Wendover, I believe. Can't be along here on vehicles. Tractors are out in force today. I suppose it's a novel way to go to Tesco's. This new thing I've added to the shield on my helmet to stop the hot air just slightly too thick, so lifting my lid up. Is I actually think we're here. That's what it feels like. So, trying to go slow. This is a 15. This is windy. Trying to keep off that gravel. Failing. Oh, that was really good. Right, so we're here. Just gonna get me bearings, get my gear off. Actually, I'm gonna show you that. Right? So hold on a minute, I'm just gonna dismount. So I'm gonna put it on. This ground's soft. So. Okay. Lock on. Right. So here's a quick walk around. There's the bike. Hopefully you can see that. And there's my bag of bits. Bit precarious, but I haven't got top box yet. I'll block all that out. So there you go. There's my bike. Okay, I'm gonna dismount all this stuff and be back soon. Don't go away.